So I'm gonna say it. The world has had enough basic captions like high tides, good vibes, seize the day, or tropic like it's hot. I'm not hating on people who use these captions, and I think there's a time and place for this, but I think with how times are going like right now in the world, I think the world could use a lot more authenticity, positivity, and just a lot more wholesomeness in general. So today, I'm gonna share 6 ways to create an authentic and real presence on social media. Hi everyone, I'm Joji LaBeouf, and I help people grow their blogs and work from home at travelingpetitegirl.com. So whether you're a blogger, freelancer, content creator, YouTuber, coach, or a business owner, creating an authentic presence on social media is what's going to help connect you to your followers. Think of it as a way to humanize your brand. Even if you are running a one-person show on your blog or your business, it's not quite straightforward to make yourself appear as a relatable person to talk to. And humans connect with humans. They don't connect with a collection of pictures they see from one person. Being authentic on social media also means showing your personality and your point of view in your life. And if your niche is really oversaturated, what better way to make yourself stand out than by promoting the one thing that people can't take away from you? Yourself. You know the phrase, your vibe attracts your tribe? You'll end up attracting more of people who hold the same values as you. And these are the kinds of people you want in your following, because whatever you say, they're going to relate with it too. So your following becomes much more loyal and much more stronger. And it's much better to have 1,000 people who are aligned with your values than 10,000 people who follow you because you post nice pictures. That type of following is not sustainable, and eventually these people are going to be unfollowing you. That and people automatically assume every social media presence they come across is really just surface level content, or it's just what they see in the pictures. So by bringing out your authenticity and being real, you actually get plus points for doing that. Alright, so how to be authentic and real on social media. Number one, speak from the heart, not from what gets the most likes. So post because you have something to share, not because your editorial calendar says you have to. Don't force yourself to say something basic or something of no value, because your followers can easily tell when you're posting just for the sake of posting. But when you're a blogger, I get that you want to keep yourself relevant and in the eyes of your followers, just in case they might forget you or for any other reason like that. And let me just tell you, in my experience of vlogging in the last few years, you don't have to do that, no. So I used to post really pretty travel photos on my Instagram, and I would get lots of likes. And whenever I got these likes, it would tell me like, oh, okay, this is doing well, I should post more things like this. But eventually it made me realize how superficial that was, because I was going after likes, but not really showing who I was, not really sharing my own experiences. And from a social media marketing standpoint, likes don't really represent how well your presence is. What's much more important is getting people to take action. So having people showing up in your direct messages, in your emails, visiting your blog, or buying something from you. Because anyone can like a photo, it's so easy. All you have to do is double tap on the image and then ready scroll down to the next one. And then repeat, 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 and just keep doing that. So speak about how you really feel, what's going on in your mind, what you feel in your heart, what struggle you're going with. What you say in your captions doesn't always have to relate to what's in your photo. And when you find that when you speak from the heart and share yourself, you'll find that you actually get a lot more comments, much more direct messages and emails just by sharing yourself. And at the end of the day, it's those DMs and emails that matter the most, not the number of likes that you get. I'm actually really glad that Instagram removed the number of likes we see on the photos, because it's not important, and usually it's a number we equate to our self-worth, and it's not true. And if you're worried about the different social media algorithms on Instagram or Facebook, I say just post like there's no algorithm. Free yourself from that burden and you realize that there's no algorithm to compete with. Number two, give up looking good. You know how when you go to someone's Instagram feed and you see perfect pictures, perfect backgrounds, perfect looking outfits? I think they're really great to look at and they're perfect for inspiration, but at a certain point, if that's all the person shows, it really starts to lack depth from there. And it feels very inauthentic because all they're showing is the highlight reel of your life and showing how perfect everything is when really it isn't. And even though these people probably mean well in posting these pictures, they need to understand the impact it could have on their brand and on their followers. I feel like it creates this barrier of blogger to following. This person has a real life and this one doesn't. But these group of people want to have a life like this person when really this person doesn't have a life like that's perfect like this at all. So if you're always posting picture perfect photos like with perfect lighting, perfect perfect backgrounds, perfect outfits. I recommend staggering your photos with unedited pictures, showing what's actually going on in your life, showing something that's the behind the scenes of your blog. At this point, your followers already like you for the content you create and the inspiration that you give them. And now they want to know more about you. So go ahead and share more about yourself in a way that's raw so that they can get to know you more and connect with you better. So I used to follow a lot of people who shared really amazing photos of them traveling around the world. I use them as inspiration for places that I want to travel to and add to my bucket list. But eventually I stopped following them because I couldn't relate to them anymore. Their Instagram feeds turned into wearing gowns in the middle of a forest or wearing beautiful dresses at the top of this mountain that they had to hike. It just wasn't realistic to me. It didn't align with my values when it came to travel or just experiencing life itself, so I went ahead and unfollowed them. Number three, share a vulnerable experience. It's really easy to post good news and share fun updates on social media. They're really exciting, so why wouldn't we share them? But I challenge you to share an experience that leaves you feeling vulnerable. So what's something about yourself or a life experience that you have that you can share that makes you feel like you're shedding your clothes in front of people? What will make you feel vulnerable when you share it? Usually this is sharing an insecurity, a weakness, or a shortcoming that we have. Acknowledging that we have it, really owning that we have these weaknesses and insecurities, and it makes us feel human, and this is something that we can share with our following to have them relate to us as a person and as a human being. So Brené Brown, the author of The Power of Vulnerability, talks about how vulnerability is the new leadership, and nothing is more stronger than a person making themselves vulnerable in front of the people who look up to them. So share those insecurities and your weaknesses and be real. Your followers will appreciate you even more. So when I first started my social media account for Traveling Petite Girl, my presence was much more like a happy-go-lucky, carefree person, little girl traveling around the world. And I was sharing a lot of inspiring travel content for solo female travelers. People were sending me messages like, "I love how inspiring your content is. You're so happy and you're so carefree. I wish I could be like you." And yeah, I'm really this bright, bubbly person when you meet me face to face, but I have such a bright and positive outlook in my life because of a dark past that I had. So Kiona of How Not to Travel Like a Basic Bitch.com had this guest post opportunity asking her followers to share their experiences with long distance relationships. I wanted to share my experience of how my long distance relationship didn't have a happy ending. It actually turned into a toxic, abusive relationship. And it was something that took years and a lot of work to recover from. And at the end of it, gave me a positive outlook in life. And if you want to hear more of that story, you can click the link in the description box. I won't go over it here. But just by sharing that experience and sharing something real that happens to people, I had so many messages in my inbox and so many emails from people sharing their experiences with me and how they're really glad that they're not alone and how they're learning that the relationship they're in was actually abusive. Some of these people didn't even know they were in an abusive relationship until they read my experience. They saw me as someone who went through some hardships and saw me as an even brighter inspiration because I did go through something that was really tough and really came out fine and happy and living like my best life at the end. So I invite you to share a vulnerable experience that happened to you that you can share with your followers that would be really helpful to them. And you don't have to do something as big as I did. And know that your story can be a huge help to other people. So if you have a vulnerable experience to share that you know will help others, do it. Get over the fear of looking bad and help your community. And your community will grow bigger after that. Number four, stop being nice and stand up for what you believe in. So there's a difference between being nice and being kind. Being kind means you're caring for someone because you really care deeply about them. Being nice means being polite because you don't want to rock the boat. And that's not authentic because you're not expressing what you truly feel. So share what you mean to say and take a stand. If you are for a movement that helps people, stand up for that. Share your point of view on that. And if you're scared of getting less likes or losing your followers, I say that's the goal. You really want to lose the people. You don't want people following you who are not aligned with your values. And by getting rid of these followers, you make space for more followers of people who actually love you because you take a stand and share your voice and create a platform for others to share their voice too. Number five, take a breather from social media. So I say you can't be authentic on social media and share your life experiences if you're not experiencing life itself. unplug from the internet, go outside and meet people. And I know there's coronavirus now, so you might be on lockdown or have a lot of restrictions, but just do something new. Take a hike, start painting, learn something new, take on the challenge even if you know you're going to fail at it. At least you did it and you can come back to social media and share those experiences and the lessons you learned and your biggest takeaways to your followers. That way your followers can learn from you and take action in their own life. I've definitely taken breaks from social media from 1 month long breaks to 6 month long breaks. I think it's very important because there's just so much information that your mind is taking in just by scrolling and scrolling on Instagram or on Facebook or on Reddit or wherever you are at. Give your brain some space to breathe and your body to relax and just collect itself. That way, when you come back onto social media, you're a lot more energized and have a lot to share. And your followers will realize how much they miss you and they're glad that you took break. And number six, none of the things I said just matter if you're not authentic to yourself first. So start with the source. So acknowledge the kind of life you're living. Are you happy with it? Are you generally happy in your own life? If you're not, take responsibility and make changes. Acknowledge your insecurities, your shortcomings, and your weaknesses, like I mentioned before. I say you can't be authentic to yourself if you're not acknowledging the things you don't like about yourself. And if you don't know how to be authentic to yourself, do some inner work and invest in yourself and start living a life that you know is true to you. Take self-development classes, read self-help books, listen to mindset podcasts. Immerse yourself in the environment of self-development and soon enough you'll be living your most authentic life. So one of the best decisions I ever made was taking self-development courses in my early 20s. It's been 8 years since I've been doing this self-development work and I don't know where my life would be without it today. If I didn't invest in my self-development, I'd probably still be living in the US, working a job I didn't like, and self-sabotaging a relationship with my boyfriend because I never fully recovered from the abuse I had from my previous boyfriend. But right now, I'm living my dream life, working online, helping others, in the most healthiest and amazing relationship with my new husband, and we just moved to Germany. And we're looking forward to all the travel that we get to do here in the next few years. I'm really happy to be here, and it took a lot of work. And I promise you, once you invest in your self-development, everything else will follow. And you'll start living a life that's really true to you, your calling, your purpose, and sharing that with other people. And when you share that authenticity on social media and with your following, it's going to create a domino effect with other people. And that's what I'm a stand for, that people get to live a life that's true to them and that they give themselves permission to live a bold and happy life. Whew, I felt like that was really deep. But I'm really glad members in my Facebook group requested for this video and I feel like it was something I've been wanting to talk about for a while, just how to be authentic. So here's a recap of 6 ways to create an authentic and real presence on social media. Number 1, speak from the heart and not what gets the most likes. Number 2, give up looking good. Screw the highlight reel and share something that's real and unedited. Number 3, share a vulnerable experience. Get over the fear of looking bad or losing followers. And share an experience that you might not be proud of in your life, but you know will help people. Number 4, stop being nice and stand up for what you believe in. Share what you truly feel and say what you mean to say, regardless if your following will like it or not. Number 5, take a breather from social media. Take as long as you need, 1 month, 6 months, 1 year. Your following will always be there and it will go stronger and faster after that. Number 6, immerse yourself in the environment of self-development. So take self-development courses, read self-help books, listen to mindset podcasts. So that's it for today's video and I hope you learned a thing or two on how to be authentic on social media. Let me know what your biggest takeaway was in the comments. And if you need some support for blogging, feel free to join my Facebook group, The Bold Blogger Mastermind, and you can find it in this link over here. I also have the link down in the description box. If you have any questions, comment them down below, and if you need someone to talk to, feel free to reach out to me on my Instagram at travelingpetitegirl. Thank you for being here and for listening to me. My name is Jojo LaBeouf, and I help people grow their blogs and work from home at travelingpetitegirl.com. Please like and subscribe to my channel for more tips every week. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!